1991, entrepreneurship in India was subdued, capital was limited, and the country had very few success stories. Revision in the Indian economy changed the competitive landscape. Business opportunities in India were manifold, and success for small businesses became the result of evolving technology, great innovation, strong execution, and customer orientation.
Company-specific data entry.
If you are successful in logistics, you have already got it.
Big Bazaar, who are our major customers.
How much is B2B and how much is B2C?
Have that right.
What is it that you do really well?
An advertisement company.
How are you going to really...
At Leaders of Tomorrow, our mission is to inspire entrepreneurs and small business owners from the four corners of India through winning pitch brought to you by Wadhwani Foundation.
100 square feet area.
What you're doing is amazing.
I appreciate your point.
I'll take it forward.
On our journey in the Eastern Zone, we will be joined by India's biggest entrepreneurs, investors, newsmakers, and game changers. Our first jury member has helped reshape India's infrastructure landscape with his game-changing ideas. He's none other than the chairman of Srei Infrastructure Finance, Hemant Kanoria. Our second jury member has bolstered the startup ecosystem by mentoring and guiding them to success. He's founder and partner at 100x.vc, Sanjay Mehta. Next is someone who is a leader and businessman who played an integral role in the growth and success of one of India's biggest FMCG companies. Introducing the managing director of SKA Advisors, Sunil Alagh. Our fourth jury member is a businessman who is always in search of the next big thing. He is the chairman of Clix Capital and founder of Genpact, Pramod, Bhasin. Our final jury member is part of the key driver of entrepreneurship in India through Wadhwani Foundation's program for entrepreneurs. He is none other than the executive vice president of Wadhwani Advantage, Samir Sathe.
Hello and welcome to Leaders of Tomorrow, India's only daily television platform for small businesses. On this season of Leaders of Tomorrow, we present Winning Pitch, brought to you by Wadhwani Foundation, a first-of-its-kind reality television program where entrepreneurs from across the country present to the biggest jury members and investors from across India Inc. And in this special episode, we continue with more pitches from the Eastern Zone of Winning Pitch, brought to you by Wadhwani Foundation. Have a look.
Our first company tonight is Kalinga Renewable Energy Manufacturers, which is developing state-of-the-art renewable energy technology. Take a listen to their pitch.
Briefly, we bring energy to livelihood. We have showed with minimal input from farmer, within a year, with half acre land, he or she can earn 1 lakh rupees. In fact, we introduced the first solar micro pump in India that is certified by Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, which became an industry benchmark. We installed the largest number of pumps around India, primarily in Odisha, UP, and Bihar. And after our work, two governments, Odisha government and Jharkhand government, have now tendered 5,000 solar micro pumps. We're a five-year-old company. We have been profitable since its inception. Our pump cost about 50,000 rupees. We have tie up with the bank so that they can pay 20% of margin, and the rest they can pay in staggered amount after the crop is cultivated. And this is less than what they actually buy in the diesel pumps. We are looking for this year close to 10 crores. We have already achieved 6 crores. One of our VP is now in the US raising another $500,000. With that, thank you.
So are you doing a system integration of buying all these particular products? Are you having a manufacturing plant where you are manufacturing any of these items?
Right. We manufacture the electronics part, so we can get pumps. And what we found, the best pump we found from one organization, which is where we're using it. So the key electronics part, and we have a patent through IIT Bhubaneswar, is what we, our, you know, USP, if you want to tell.
And what about the solar panel?
Yeah, so the solar panels that it's a customized, because we need, as I said, that we have designed so that with the minimal panel, which is where the cost comes, because the pump costs about 10,000 rupees, 12,000 rupees. You take A panel, B, A pump, B pump, C pump. So because of our design that I mentioned to you, we customize with 3 to 4 solar manufacturers. They, with our technical specification, this is the voltage, this is the current they give us.
How long does the solar panel last every day? I mean, how much, how long can the pump work for?
Yeah, right now, for example, as we speak, the solar pump can start around 7 o'clock in the morning, and it can go all the way to about 5 o'clock. Of course, in the, let's say during the cloudy days, it gets shorter. But guess what? It's needed when you have more sun. You don't need when it's cloudy or it's raining. So that is how it works.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Next is a company which sells fresh milk through a subscription model. Listen in to Umananda Dairy's pitch.
When I started, and the problem that we faced, even in my previous venture, which was a dairy, was that people were not getting fresh milk. So all the scalable models, something like Amul and other companies, the processed milk that reaches our houses is almost 15 to 20 days old. And this was an issue that was concerning me. And that is why I read up if fresh milk can be scalable. We are doing through right now is a subscription model, which right now we are selling packaged milk. Very soon, the from the next fundraising round, we will get into processed milk items. Later stages, we will also get into other items such as green fodder and vermicompost, monetizing the waste component. Right now, our milk, I mean, we are looking at end to end. So the basic idea why we started with a captive dairy farm is because there was no ecosystem as such in the Northeast as such. So once we, right now what we are doing is we will probably create a model where we, the farmers will be our suppliers. They will, we will provide them with the best quality breed cows. We will provide them with, we are already working with 300 farmers who are growing green fodder for us.
Neeraj, we're out of time. I'm sorry. I'll just go to the jury for their questions.
Yeah, Neeraj, a couple of comments. One is in, if you look at your projections, financials, that scale that you're anticipating is not exciting enough. So that's my one comment. Second is in dairy business, it's very important to look at fat as a component. That's where the money lies. I haven't heard anything from you on the fat element. Third is in terms of, if you look at you know, what you're trying to do in terms of quality and other areas, which is good. But I think from the margins point of view also, if you look at your own projections, they don't look exciting enough.
Regarding the first point, the projection that I've given is only from the funds that's going to be raised in the coming round. That is about 2 crores, of which already 1 crore we've raised. Coming to the second part, fat part of the milk, our average fat as of now is about 4.2 to 4.5, with scalability, as I said, on the first question, definitely this is only for this fundraising, the projections are given. Along the way, in the last 5 years that we've learned, so it is a very scalable model, and definitely the numbers are much better than what it looks like.
How long will it take for the investor to get the money back?
We are already, were profitable last year, though it's still a very small scale. But even for this round, we are looking at a 4 to 5 year. Even the numbers, we've already raised 1 crore from net fee, and they are looking at an exit within 5 years. It's already incorporated in the plan. So we are only looking at balance 1 crore funding of the 2 crores that we are looking to raise.
See, the kind of investors that you want to look at might be different. So for example, IFC does a lot of long-term investments and funds in dairy industry also, which are looking at a horizon of 5 years, 7 years, 8 years. So you might want to give it a thought.
It could be impact investors also. There's a lot of social impact funds. I mean, we run one called Asha Impact, which might be interested.
So far, I've always participated in impact investment funds only.
Right.
I mean, probably this
those may be the places to go to, you know. Certainly, we'd be interested through that fund, not
fantastic. Directly, okay, so in some way or the other, that's an intention to invest.
It's time for a short break, but we'll be right back with more exciting pitches on the other side. So don't go anywhere. Welcome back to Leaders of Tomorrow Presents Winning Pitch, brought to you by Wadhwani Foundation. And now we bring you the pitches of the last few candidates from our Eastern Zone.
The next company tonight is aiming to provide superior quality cosmetic products to mass consumers. Take a listen to Pile Novelty's pitch.
This company we started in 2012, about 8 years ago. और सिंगल प्रोडक्ट बिंदी के साथ में उसके पहले दो साल मैंने अपने ही लोकल एरिया में एफएमसीजी के काफ़ी सारे कंपनीज के डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन शिप लेकर थोड़ा स्टडी करने की कोशिश की थी कि मार्केट को क्या प्रोडक्ट चाहिए. पहले चार साल सिर्फ हम एक ही प्रोडक्ट के साथ चल रहे थे उड़ीसा के अंदर में और दूसरा स्टेट भी हमने ओपन नहीं किया था. चार साल बाद हमने कुछ तीन चार प्रोडक्ट्स ऐड किए थे जैसे काजल, कुमकुम, सिंदूर और सब इकोनॉमिक प्रोडक्ट था. और हमारा आइडिया यही था कि मास कंज्यूमर के इंटरेस्ट को सर्व करना. 2013-14 में 77 लाख का टर्नओवर हमने किया था और हर साल ये टर्नओवर बढ़ते ही गया था. जैसे 14-15 में 1.21 का, 15-16 1.4 और 16-17 में टर्नओवर लगभग डबल हो गया था क्योंकि हमने तीन चार प्रोडक्ट्स उसमें ऐड किए थे. अभी जो हमारा टारगेट है वो साउथ इंडिया के मार्केट्स में फोकस करने का है क्योंकि ये सब थोड़ा रिलीजियस एरिया जहाँ बिंदी, कुमकुम या काजल टाइप के प्रोडक्ट्स ज़्यादा यूज होते हैं. ये एक कॉम्पिटिटर पहला जो लाइन है वो हमारा सेल्स है. सेकंड एक कॉम्पिटिटर ब्रांड का सेल है, सिर्फ एक ही ब्रांड का जो कि साउथ इंडिया के हैं. ये डाटा मैं यहाँ इसलिए दे रहा हूँ ताकि आप अंडर एस्टिमेट ना करें कि मतलब एक बिंदी या एक नेल पॉलिश, एक सिंदूर, मतलब इतना बड़ा मार्केट है क्या उसका. हमारी सेल्स थी करीब दोनों मिला के ऊपर के 2 करोड़ के, तो वो कंपनी की सेल है 27 करोड़ का.
आप कह रहे थे कि आपका प्राइस कम है, आप बेच रहे हैं जो कंपेटिटर के प्राइस पे, तो फिर अगर कंपेटिटर आपका ब्रांड उन्होंने बिल्ड किया है तो फिर आपके पास क्यों आएंगे वो. आप तो डीलर मार्जिन ज्यादा दे रहे हैं, क्या कुछ ना कुछ तो आप कर रहे हैं जो टियर टू टियर थ्री सिटीज में या तो वो डिस्ट्रीब्यूट नहीं कर रहे हैं या आपने डीलर पुश के हिसाब से अगर उनको 10 रुपए में उनको 1 रुपया मिल रहा है तो आपने 3 रुपया दिया, क्या किया आपने.
ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है कि हम कुछ नया टाइप का चीज नहीं कर रहे हैं या डीलर को भी ज्यादा मार्जिन नहीं दे रहे. प्राइस भी हमारा और उनका ऑलमोस्ट सेम है. हम बस ये कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि भीड़ तो हर प्रोडक्ट में मतलब हर जगह है, हम बस भीड़ में उतर के थोड़ी अपनी जगह बनाने की कोशिश करें. पिछले 7 साल से
आप कह रहे हैं 3 करोड़ का टर्नओवर है, कितना?
4 करोड़ का पिछले साल.
तो अपनी जगह कैसे बना रहे हैं, क्या कर रहे हैं जो आपकी जगह बन रही है.
ऑर्गेनाइज्ड वे में बिंदिया बेचने वाली बहुत कंपनी नहीं है, सिर्फ 2 ब्रांड है ऑल ओवर इंडिया में. रिटेलर्स के थ्रू हम पहली बार में थोड़ा पुश करवाते हैं अपने सेल को, या तो रिटेलर्स को एक्स्ट्रा स्कीम या मार्जिन दे के. और फर्स्ट टाइम अगर रिटेलर एक बार अगर कंज्यूमर को दे दिए और कंज्यूमर अगर सेटिस्फाइड है तो वो अगली बार हमारा ही पत्ता लेके जाते हैं वहाँ पे कि ये बिंदी हमको चाहिए. तो ये ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम बिल्ड होता है, मतलब एकदम से नहीं हो जाता है.
तो आप बिंदियाँ बनवाते हैं, पैकेजिंग करते हैं, क्या करते हैं?
थर्ड पार्टी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग करवाते हैं. हालांकि वो फैक्ट्री टोटली हमारे लिए ही चलती है.
तो आपके नाम पर बिकती है, आपके ब्रांड ने?
हाँ जी, पर्ल हमारे ब्रांड का नाम है.
अच्छा
जी,
ओके, थैंक यू पराग फॉर योर टाइम.
Next is a company that designs, develops, manufactures and provides technical and service support for scientific research. Listen in to AdLab Solutions pitch.
We are a one-stop solution for engineering products. Our core market is right now we are extensively working in academic products. So basically what we do is that in a very simple language, we are the interior designer for engineering products. So what is the problem scenario? If I consider the academic market, most of the equipment which academic market are purchasing are foreign make. So what these foreign companies are doing, they hire some local vendor, and this local vendor is just a Modi Khana Dukan, and they sell their product to the academic institutions. So most of the time, the customer requirement is not met with the required product. This particular company I have started in 2018. First year turnover was 54 lakhs. Second year till date, the turnover was is around 2 crore 5 lakhs. And if you calculate from January 2019 to February 2020, I had made a revenue total turnover of 2.5 crore in which I have made a profit, gross profit of 90 lakh rupees. This 90 lakhs profit has been generated by just 35 purchase order and 17 clients. So the my average purchase order per client is around 12 lakh rupees. This is the fund we require it, 2 crore for initial setup and 2 crore for working capital for the bigger opportunity like 2 crore and 5 crore. With this proposition, I have one more offer for the investor, and the offer is that leave the expense part to me. I will take care. Just fund me when I get a big order of 10 crore, order of 5 crore. Just fund me on that, take the 10 stick revenue on that, plus 10% annual interest on the particular amount.
We're out of time, so let's move to the jury for their questions.
Yeah. What do you do? What's the business?
We are a one-stop solution for engineering products. So what we do, I can tell with one of the examples. This is our product. And like this, we have 1,000 plus design and product or solution, you can say. Okay? Now, with this same specification product, the lowest cost or the lowest selling price is 2.5 lakh rupees, correct? I'm selling it at a 1 lakh plus tax. Now, the cost of manufacturing this particular hardware is just 4,500 rupees. Like this, I have 1,000 plus design and solution. You just consider, sir, if I just talk about academic market, it is really untapped market. Say for example, sir, you have a technical institutions, okay? So that particular technical institution want to set some laboratory, okay?
Okay.
So in this laboratory, there are a lot of things has been required.
Right.
Fine. Now there is not a single company in this world, I'm talking about in this world, who is giving complete 100% complete laboratory solution.
Who is your market? Is it just the labs? Or who else is your market?
Any technical institution, any engineering college, any DRDO funded DRDO institutions, all are our market.
Okay, Robin, we're out of time. So yeah. Thank you to the jury. Thank you for that, Robin. Yeah, thank you.
Next up is Buoyancy Solutions, a company which is aiming to help daily wagers earn a livelihood. Take a listen to their pitch.
Typically, if you go and see in your locality, there are a lot of people who are waiting for the daily services, waste-based daily services, and they don't know where to go. Where to go for the work, and the people are looking for the services, and they don't know where to go for their services job. So what we're trying to do is basically bring these two people in our common platform, which is called basically a color job. And what we're trying to do is bring this plumber, electrical, skill, music, all those people in this platform, get them registered. And some of them will be professionally people. We try to get them into our platform and provide their needs daily to daily services requirement from the customer segment who are basically household people. As for our revenue model is concerned, we are trying to do it subscription-based, advertisement-based, and bulk contract monitoring system.
Explain your financial model, because there are many companies and platforms which have been created to provide all the services that you are mentioning.
Our distinct factor is bringing the number of unskilled labor force based in a particular location and increase the mass. And based on the subscription for each skill for people who will be registering into that platform, let's say 50 rupees or 200 rupees per month or every 3 months, and we try to increase that number of people in a locality. That will be one of our major subscription-based revenue model. Second model is from that same locality, we know who are the people are going to provide that particular, let's say, parts, or let's say the items which is required, you have to replace the pipe. So they know which hardware shops are nearby. So we'll be going to them to promote their products. And third is obviously contract, which is bulk, which means let's say one of the apartment where you have 20 people, they cannot afford to have a yearly contract with some electrical people. So we are saying, fine, you give us yearly subscription, let's say 500 rupees or 1,000 rupees, whenever you need, we'll supply you the workforces. So these are the major three things. We are basically relying on number of people who will register as a customer, as well as the service provider in our platform.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much, gentlemen.
Now let's take a look at the score tally for the final five contestants who pitched in this episode. Let's see which one of them managed to impress our jury and investors. The green light on your screen indicates an intention to invest on the part of our investors. It's finally time to unveil the final five winners of the Eastern Zone of Winning Pitch, brought to you by Wadhwani Foundation. The first winner to enter the finale is Sabse Sasta Dukan. Our second finalist tonight is Eggos. Our third finalist tonight to make it to the finale from the Eastern Zone is Aralic Reliability. Our fourth finalist tonight is Krishworks Technologies and Research Labs. And the fifth finalist tonight to make it to the finale is ERC iCare. The Eastern Zone of Winning Pitch, brought to you by Wadhwani Foundation, was a success with seven contestants seeing an intention to invest on the part of our investors. Before we end, let's see what some of our jury members had to say about the Eastern Zone of Winning Pitch, brought to you by Wadhwani Foundation.
Winning Pitch is an excellent platform. I think this is a fantastic idea that we at Wadhwani Foundation, as a leader of Wadhwani Advantage Program, in association with the ET Now, have sort of cooked up. Because at the end of the day, Indian entrepreneurs need platform. They need platform to be able to voice their idea, to be able to actually get funds. And this is fantastic because you have a great combination of knowledge and reach.
The experience was exhilarating. Loved the Winning Pitch Leaders of Tomorrow show. It has been a great journey being part of all the zones and looking forward to the final. And I'm sure final is going to be very, very, very exciting.
Well, that's all that we could manage to fit in this episode of Leaders of Tomorrow. But on the next episode of Leaders of Tomorrow Presents Winning Pitch, brought to you by Wadhwani Foundation, we bring you an in-depth look at the backstories of the five winners that made it through to the grand finale. With that, it's a wrap. Thanks for watching.